Hello guys, welcome you for another session on software engineering. Today we are going to see about project scheduling in unit 5. Let us see what is project scheduling. On larger projects, 100 of small tasks must occur to accomplish the larger goal. So your project has to be split into different number of smaller tasks to complete the project. So who will did this goals means the project manager. So what is the objective of project manager? So he will define all the project tasks, build an activity network that depicts their interdependencies, and identify the tasks that are critical within the activity network, and build the timeline depicting the planned and actual progress of each task, and track task progress to ensure that delay in recognized one day at a time. So these are all the activities which going to be done in the project schedule. To do this, the schedule should allow the progress to be monitored and the project to be controlled. So your schedule should be monitored by the project manager. So after that, software project scheduling distribute estimated effort across the planned project duration by allocating the effort to the specific task. For each and every task, there will be some time will be allocated. So in that particular time, your task has to be completed. So a target will be fixed for every task. Schedule for projects can be viewed from two different perspectives. In that, the first perspective is nothing but an end date for release of computer-based software. So that is the target date. So for every project, there will be a end date that we call it as a delivery date. So within the delivery date, your project has to be completed. So what is that second view? So assuming that rough chronological bounds have been discussed, but that end date is set by the software engineering organization. So for each and every task, you will be having a date for completion, and also you have a delivery date for the entire project. So your date will be fixed only by the software engineering organization, not by the customer. So your organization should know when to complete the project, and within that duration, you have to complete all the defined tasks, each and every defined task, and the resources have to be allocated for completing the task. So that is what we have to do in the project scheduling. So we have a basic principles for scheduling. The first one is nothing but compartmentalization. It means which will define the distinct task. So in your project, in your complex project, we have to identify different tasks. That task identification is called as compartmentalization. Next principle is interdependencies. This will indicate the interrelationship between each and every task. So if you know the relationship between the tasks, your work will be minimized. And third principle is effort validation. It will make sure that resources are available. For each and every task, a person will be allocated, a person or a group of person will be allocated to complete the task. So here we will validate the effort. So by how do we validate effort means we have allocated the resources for completing all the tasks, whether all the resources are utilized by the resource persons, that will calculate the effort. And next principle is defined responsibilities. So the people who are assigned for the task will have some responsibilities. And next principle is defined outcomes. From each and every task, we will have an output. So that have to be measured. So each task must have an output. That output should be measurable. And the next principle is defined milestones. Milestone will be achieved only by reviewing the quality of the task. While you complete your task, the output has to be measured. Your output should be a quality output. So that is why it will be defined milestone. And the first task is you have to define the task set. So how do we define the task set? So task set is nothing but the work breakdown structure of the project. So your entire project is breakdown into smaller tasks. Your tasks are compiled into a breakdown structure. So that breakdown structure is called as task set. No single task set is appropriate for all the project. So for each and every project, you should allocate a separate task set, and your process models and all varying depends upon the project type. And also we have to assess the degree of rigor required. So the rigor is nothing but influential factor. So what are all the factors which is influencing your project? The task set should provide enough discipline to achieve the highest software quality. So each and every task set will achieve a software quality. And your task network. So how do we define the task network? So task network is nothing but we will be defining with this diagram. So we have to identify the concept first, concept scoping. So wherever we have to apply that concept, for each and every task there will be some concept. So we have to find the scope for the concept, then we are going for the planning of the concept. After that, the tasks are applied in three parallel different concept functions. So your concept function has been parallelly working by technical risk assessment. So 1.3 A, B, C are the three parallel different concept functions. So each and every one is the technical risk assessment. After that, proof for concept. So when we are assess the risk, so after assessing the risk, we will get the proof. So we will finally come into what are all the risks we are available that will be drafted. So after that, we have going to implement the concept. So for implementing concept also, we have three different parallel concept functions. So before to that, we have assessed the three different concepts, and now we are going to implement the three different concepts in a different task. So here is how we are splitting. So here we are having three different task of a single concept. So in a single concept, we are splitting it into three different tasks, and we are implementing that concept. Later to that, we are integrating all the ABCs are integrated, and then we are moving it to the customer. So customer will have a reaction on that concept. So we are taking a concept, and we are finding the scope of the concept, and we are planning to complete. Here is what we are scheduling the concept, and by that scheduling we are dividing it into three different tasks, and we are assessing the risk for three different tasks, and we are finally get the risk assessment as a proof. And after that, we are implementing the concept in the three different tasks, and later to that, we are integrating into single unit, and we are moving it to the customer for their feedback. So how do we schedule the how do we track the schedule? So we already implement a schedule. So based on that schedule, we are moving in, we are developing the project, and while developing the project, we have to assess whether the schedule have been properly implemented or not. So for that, we have two different approach: qualitative approach and quantitative approach. In qualitative approach, we have to conduct the periodic project status meeting. So we have to arrange a meeting. In that meeting, the resource persons, the developers, will convey what is the status of our project. So in which each team member report the progress and problems what they are facing. And next, we have to evaluate the result of all the reviews conducted throughout the software engineering process. So we have to conduct reviews regularly, and also evaluate the result of the reviews, and determine whether formal project milestones have been accomplished by the scheduled date. Only with the help of calculating the milestone, we are calculating the percentage of project completion based on the milestone. Compare actual start date to planned start date for each project task listed in the resourceable table. So already I told you that the project will be breakdown into different tasks. Each and every task will have a start date and end date. So we have to check whether each and every task have been started in the correct date, and then meet informally with practitioners to obtain their subjective assessment of the progress to date and problem on the horizon. Up to date, whether each and every practitioner is nothing but your developers. So we have to the project manager or schedule manager will visit them and inquire about the project completion, and also they have to check whether the progress date is correct. So the task will be started in a start date and it will be ended in a end date. So in between that, we have to check whether your task have been going on the proper scheduled date and what are the problems on the process. So in that particular scheduled date, that is called as horizon. In that horizon, any problems which is faced by the practitioners, that has to be analyzed. So these are all the qualitative approach. Then we are moving on to quantitative approach. So we have to use the earned value analysis technique. So it is a special technique which is useful to assess the progress quantitatively. So we have to measure the progress. So how to measure the progress will be shown in the earned value analysis. Okay, let us move on. Earned value analysis. Earned value analysis is nothing but the measure of the progress. In our schedule, we have given different tasks for the developers. So developers will do on the task. So we have to, the project manager or schedule manager will ensure, or they have to measure whether the progress is going on right or not. So it will enable us to assess the percent of completeness. So we are here quantitatively measure how much percentage the project have been completed, completion of the project, using quantitative analysis rather than the gut feeling. So we are not going to assess by ourselves whether the project have been scheduled and this will go on. So we have to measure it quantitatively. So here it will provide accurate and reliable readings of the performance from as early as 15% into the project. So this is given by a scientist, suggestions given by a scientist, that whenever we use the earned value analysis, as early as 15% we are getting into the project performance. So that is what the output we are expected from the earned value analysis. So how to compute earned value analysis? So for computing earned value analysis, we have to find the budgeted cost of work scheduled, BCWS. BCWS is nothing but budgeted cost of work scheduled. So the schedule which we already did will have a budgeted cost to complete that schedule. That budgeted cost have to be assigned for each and every task. That is why we call it as BCWSI. So it means for each and every task we have a budgeted cost of work scheduled for the effort planned for work task I. For every work task I, the effort we have to plan, the effort, the effort is nothing but the cost which we want to spend on the task. To determine the progress at given point along the project schedule, the value of BCWS is sum of the BCWSI. And so in our schedule we have different tasks. So for each and every task we have a BCWS, that is budgeted cost of work schedule. So here we want to sum all the BCWSI to create a complete budget at completion. So here is how we are measuring that. The BCWS values for all the work tasks are summed to derive the budget at completion, BAC. So BAC is the final budget for completing your process, completing your project. So here we have to sum all the BCWSI for all the task K. So your BCWSI will be summed into BCWS. So BCWS is nothing but work task. So this is what work task. So each and every work task will be summation into form a BAC, final budget at completion. So this is what BAC, final budgeted at completion. Next, so next we want to calculate the budgeted cost of work performed, BCWP. The scheduled work have to be have been already calculated. This is what the work performed. So this, the value of BCWP is the sum of BCWS, the value for all the work tasks that have actually been completed by the point in time on the project schedule. At any given time, at any given point, what are the tasks that have been completed, that task BCWS have been taken, and sum of all these BCWS will be sum of all BCWS will be BCWP. BCWP is nothing but work performed, budgeted cost of work performed. Next, the given values of BCWS, BAC and BCWP, we are calculating the performance index. So that is scheduled performance index. Scheduled performance index will be calculated based on, it is a ratio between BCWP divided by BCWS. BCWP is nothing but work performed and WS is nothing but work scheduled. The budgeted work schedule and budgeted work performed. So the ratio between these two will have a scheduled performance index. And also we have to find out scheduled variance. So what is the differences? So the differences will be calculated with the differences between work performed and the difference between work scheduled. So scheduled variance is nothing but difference between work performed and work scheduled. This difference will give the scheduled variance. So SPA is nothing but indication of the efficiency, indication of efficiency with which the project is utilized, the scheduled resources. If you utilize the scheduled resources, you will get the SPI very accurate. And next we have to calculate the percent scheduled for completion. So finally we have to calculate the actual cost. So to calculate the actual cost, we should know the schedule for completion. So the schedule for percent scheduled for completion will be calculated based on work scheduled divided by BAC. BAC is nothing but budget at completion. The total work scheduled task, the summation of all the work task. So this is the total budgeted at completion. The ratio between budgeted cost work scheduled. So already the each and every task no. The task will be divided by complete budgeted at completion. Budget at completion. This will give you the project schedule for completion. And we have this will indicate the percentage of work that should have been completed at time T. At any time T, this much work have to be completed. And percent complete. So the PC, percent complete, will be calculated by work performed. So this is nothing but work scheduled and this is the work performed. This have to be completed. This is a scheduled work and this is the actual work completion. BCWP is nothing but budgeted cost of work performed divided by total budgeted completion. This will provide a quantitative indication. This will provide the quantitative indication of the percent of completeness of the project at a given time. At a given time T, at any given time T, this much percentage of work have been completed. The work completion have been measured with this BCWP by BAC. And using all these notations, finally we are going to calculate the actual cost of work performed, ACWP. So ACWP is nothing but the sum of effort actually expended on work tasks that have been completed by the point on the project schedule. So this percent completion, so the all the percent completion summations will be taken into account for ACWP, actual cost work performed. Then using this we can compute cost performance index. So this is the cost performance index. Cost performance index will be calculated based on BCWP, budgeted cost work performed divided by actual cost of work performed. So your actual work performed and the budgeted work perform ratio will give you the cost performance index. So from after calculating the CPI, we are calculating the cost variance, CV, cost variance. Cost variance will give difference between work performed and actual cost of work performed. Budgeted cost work performed and actual cost of work performed. The difference between BCWP and ACWP will lead to cost variance. So this is how we are calculating the earned value analysis. Okay, so next we are moving on project planning. So once the project is found to be possible, the computer code project managers undertake the project designing. So project designing is well planned before starting of any development activities. So project designing consists of subsequent essential activities like estimating cost, estimating size, estimating duration and estimating effort. So now, this is the precedence ordering among the planning activities. So we have to estimate all these things. So we have a precedence first, whatever we have to estimate. So we are starting with size estimation. So after we are getting the total size of the project, we are calculating the effort which we have to apply on the apply for the project, and what are the durations which we taken for completing the project. So the effort and duration will be calculated based on the size. The effort will lead to the cost estimation. So how much effort we want to apply to the project, that much cost we have to spend on the each and every project. So the duration, so after calculating the duration, we have to plan for the project staffing. So project staffing is based on duration and also the effort what we want to put into the project. So based on the project staffing, we will get the schedule of the project. So these are all the elements which we have to focusing on the planning activities. And next we are going on the project planning process. The project planning process will have 6 different steps. So here we have to calculate the objective and scope of the project. And next we are concentrating on the techniques used to perform the project planning and effort which we put into the individual efforts which is involved in the project, and project schedule and milestones, resources required for the project and risk associated with the projects. So this will be accomplished with following activities. So whenever we are going to plan a project, we have to follow these activities. First of all, we have to identify the project requirements, and based on the requirement, we are going for identification of cost estimation and identification of risk. The requirements will given by the stakeholders. Based on the requirements, we have to estimate the cost and estimate the risk. So from both of these, we will get the critical success factor. So we have to identify the critical success factor. So how much cost we have spent and what are the risk on the project. So by getting the ratio of these two, we will get the critical success factor, whether our project will have a success or not. That will be we have to identify. So after identifying this, we have to prepare the project charter. So this is nothing but the timeline of the project completion, the starting date and ending date, delivery date of the project. So in between that, we have n number of dates. No, so we already discussed though, each and every task we have a separate date for starting the task and ending the task, and prepare the project plan. So final project plan have been prepared and commencement of the project. So these are all the activities which is performed on the project planning. Okay, that's all in this video. Thank you.